Hey and welcome to Neverwinter with Aragon. So in this video I'd like to go over a general AoE build for the Bard. So this will be focusing on the Songblade Paragon path, where you shall concentrate on maximizing your damage against multiple enemies. So this will be useful for a lot of content, from grinding out those different adventures and campaigns, along with those areas in those dungeons where you just have lots of enemies. So firstly, I'd like to give a special thank you to all of my channel members for helping me keep my channel going. So we're going to initially jump to our powers, as this will be the bread and butter of our build and what makes it viable. So with regards to our at-wills, we have a good few options here. Now, your main AoE at-will will want to be this con at-will, this one which you will change to be your con motto with the Tailwind Mambo, and I'll show you exactly what I mean. Currently this Mambo looks like so. It'll deal damage in an area around you, the con elemento, but we want to change it to the con motto, and the reason being is so that it will give us this ability. We cast our song Tailwind Mambo, and now we can cast these mini whirlwinds often pretty much any direction, and they'll deal lots of damage to any enemies that get hit by it. As you can see what's happening to those dummies, we can easily keep their HP down. And the reason why it's the best one out of all of the con at wills is because when you look at the cast time, it's 0.8 seconds. If we cast a different song like Flamenco, you can see that now it has a 1.2 second. And we'll go and cast a Steel March, and you can see it'll now have still a greater cast time than the Con Monto. It now has Con Brio, and it has over a 1 second cast time. See, they all have the same magnitude damage there. It's exactly the same as this one, 150, and our Tailwind Mambo one is the Con Motto at also 150. And this is very useful for dealing damage to enemies who are, let's say, in front of you. The area is quite decently sized. However, of course, if you're in an area, you might want to cast your Steel March and then have it to look like so. It'll be a large cone in front of you. It'll be quite easy to hit all of those enemies. It's up to you and your playstyle, but I believe this is the best AoE at-will to be using. This reprise is okay, reprise. However, its arc is only 200 degrees and it's quite a small cone, as you can see. So you might want to, instead of using it, as I have it as kind of my secondary at-will, use like Flesh from a Distance, Flesh, and you could then go and pick off that last enemy. It has the highest magnitude of our at-wills. Staccato, not really useful. Sure, you can use it to pick off an enemy or two, or you could use it in conjunction with this Battlefield Ostinato to gain extra damage off your con at wills. So let's move to our encounter powers. Without a doubt, Duet is our best AoE encounter power. It has the added effect of Daze and a decent magnitude of 230. You'll notice that our AoE encounters really don't have high magnitude. So 230 is like the highest one we have there, and it has the benefit to hit a lot of enemies around us. It's really neat and it just feels really good as well to be casting it. Cooldown is 15 seconds, however, so it'll take a while. But in conjunction with, let's say, our performer, we'll be able to get a lot more of those casts. Secondly, I'm using Lunge just to close the gap. It's a 60 feet distance lunge, so you can use it from quite far away. It also has a decent high magnitude of 400 there, where we'll also add the effect of stun just for 1 second. So you'll like interrupt the enemy in what they're doing. And then with our final AoE encounter power, I use my Vault Stabito, and it gives that 200 magnitude, and you'll also rush forward. As you can see when I do like here, you kind of want to go through your enemies like so. Now you do have the ability to jump and cast it, and you don't move, but you will deal the damage as if you went through them. Quite a neat trick to do, let's say you don't want to be going to the other side of the enemies. So Sometimes it seems a little buggy and won't actually hit, but that could be just with my ping, as it's not doing so great right now. As for the other encounter powers, not much use when you're just in AoE fights. And for daily powers, you could use Inspiration, but you're definitely better off just with this daily, this Encore, which will allow you to cast one of these songs instantaneously. Just pretty handy. It will, however, depend on what song you've cast last. Like, now it's Steel Encore, because I cast Steel March previously. As for our mechanics, pretty straightforward. We have our roll where we can immunity frame enemy hits. We have our tab, which is our performance, where we use to go and cast our different songs. You can use the keybinds, which I have made a video on. Just look them up. I have made 2 videos, in fact. And then we also have this free perform, not much use, and the rest of them here. You do have the ability to increase the songs up to 72 duration, which definitely gives it an advantage over the minstrel for damage. And then you do have the forte, which isn't the best power like every other DPS, and then crit severity. And for our songs, you have a bunch here, and you have these 3 songs, the Blaze Flamenco, the Tailwind Mambo, and the Steel March, and you want to have one of these active 100% of the time. It will give you the extra bonus of 20 additional magnitude on each of your hits, along with dealing 350 magnitude on that initial hit, and then depending which song you cast, you will gain the additional benefit of increasing the damage bonus for you and your nearby allies by 2%, an additional 2% for the certain damage type. So it's about 4% there. If we use our Tailwind Mambo, it changes all of our damage to projectile damage. We'll gain the additional 4% from this then, along with the extra magnitude. Pretty neat. You could also use the strength ability score to increase that damage a bit further, since all of that damage is getting reverted to projectile. Even when you're using these other encounter powers at wills, they all are turned into projectile damage, except maybe it costs features like Mystifying Strikes. So what I recommend is, as I've said, have Tailwind Mambo or Steel March active all the time. If you like to be right up close to the enemies, Blaze Flamingo could also be useful. It's just a matter of playstyle. Ideally cast it when you initially jump into a group of enemies, but you do have the disadvantage of when you go and cast a song, you can't use any powers. You can see it says you must wait longer after playing a song. So you might want to cast it while you're out of combat and thus not have to have that wait duration before you cast encounter powers to maximize your damage output and killing the enemies as quickly as possible. It's up to you. Make sure you take advantage of that. And then we also have our Ballad of the Witch. The Ballad of the Heroes for single target and the Ballad of the Witch is for AoE. You'll gain that additional 40 magnitude and the ability to perform Finale, dealing 400 damage to all enemies around you. The drawback on this is you have to cast it while in combat, and again, with casting a song within combat, you have this annoying delay before you can do anything else. It's really annoying in my opinion, but I guess it has somewhat of a balancing, especially for those of us using those quick in-game keybinds that allow you to cast a song instantly without having it in a quick play slot. So you would use this Ballad of the Witch, let's say you're in a skirmish and you're just having waves of enemies coming at you. Then you would try and have this active along with this other song, either be Tailwind Mambo or your Steel March or Flamenco. You can have them active at the same time, gaining that additional 60 magnitude to those attacks, 20 from here and another 40 from here, and the benefit of having the Finale. But you will run into issues of being able to generate that perform. That's when we go to those class features. You ideally want to have Musician's Flow for that purpose, having a chance to reduce the cost of playing a song by 50%, allowing you to cast off more Ballad of the Witches. You do have the benefit of being able to regenerate this perform pretty much instantly when out of combat, so when jumping between groups of enemies, you can generally regenerate it enough so that you'll be able to cast a song when you jump into combat again. So you might not need this Magician's Flow, and then you could switch to the Masterful Performance. Now, something I have to test out further is whether Mystifying Strikes is worth it within AoE. I don't believe it can proc on multiple enemies at once, but it has the benefit of when it does proc, you'll deal damage over time, and as soon as another ally hits that target, you'll deal 400 magnitude to the enemy, and the player who hit them will also heal for 400 magnitude. Pretty neat. These other bonuses are just not great. Of course, you would use soloist when you're solo, but generally you'll be in a party, and then Songword is more of a defensive one. Stravazando, it's okay, but 5% extra damage is like next to nothing. Advancing Parry, again, just a defensive one. Advancing Blade, it's okay, another 5% damage, but again, it's hard to maintain, especially within AoE. And as we've said, Master Performance could definitely be a viable one, just increasing the effectiveness of those three songs, which you ideally want to have 100% uptime on. Then we jump to our feats, and you could of course use backup performer to help out your healer and also help out healing party members. 1200 magnitude is not a small heal. Of course, if you're running with a tank and you want to help them with their threat, voice throw is pretty neat. Then either you want to choose your battlefield ostinato or your elemental melody. Elemental Melody is decent getting up those stacks of the extra magnitude. You can get that up to 30. You have quite a big window of 60 seconds to get those stacks up. Fairly easy. You basically just have to cast those different song types, use those at wills to cast it off, and you gain the stack, and then you can cast your second, and then you can go cast that second at will, and you gain another one of those stacks, and so on until you have that 30 magnitude buff. Arguably, that's a lot more harder to get off than just having an additional 20% damage to your at wills. And to gain the additional 20% damage, it's fairly easy. You might just have to cast off Staccato. Be warned, though, that this says it delivers a multi-hit attack to the target enemy, and you'll have to actually do this multi-hit attack to proc this off. You'd have to finish that flurry before you'll gain the benefit. So you might want to use like Fleece instead to proc it. And then you'll have that extra 20% damage bonus on your con motto. And that would be pretty neat. Then we go to our Ballad Calla voice, or you would have your Ado. Of course, you want to take the Ballad Calla voice, Voss. It basically will increase the extra effectiveness of those allies. Then we go to either Redoublement or Martial Performance. I personally like to use Martial Performance as I find Redoublement not too useful. Generally, when you're casting Vols Dubito, you just keep casting it, and then you switch to the other encounter powers when you've done casting it. But the benefit to cast them in between can be useful, but really it's only a 10% additional bonus. And if you're just having this extra magnitude on all of your attacks, that can end up just being that little bit better. Then finally, we have our fifth set of feats, either Performer or Lore Master. And in an AoE environment, Performer is definitely a lot better, giving you those additional improvised attacks. Keep in mind, an improvised version will basically reduce the magnitude of the attack by a half. So Vols Dubito with 100 magnitude is worse than just casting your at will. So keep that in mind, whether it's worth it to be using those. Like a duet, half the magnitude, you're looking at only 115 magnitude. Still is less than 150 from your con motto after you've cast that song, as you can see there, 150. So keep that in mind. Lore Master is okay, but it's hard to actually get that proc'd, and you ideally would cast it on a single target, because lore only affects one target. So now we move to the stats, and as a usual DPS, we want to be stacking up these offense statistics. In an AoE environment, ideally you want to stack power, then crit strike and crit severity, and then accuracy, and after that, the last thing you would stack up would be combat advantage, because it's much harder to obtain combat advantage when you're in an AoE environment, because enemies are generally spread all over the place, and it's very hard to keep them flanked. So my current setup is as it is, however I'm not buffed up, so let's use our buffs, and there we go. Our power capped at 90%, our crit severity and crit strike, we can get that maxed out with our gear, using Garistro and Bone Devils along with our precision. And we can get our combat advantage just there, but we could go and switch to using our Wild Hunt Rider, and that would also get it capped out at 90%. with the additional 11% from here. So that's really it. Otherwise, stack as much item level as you can and obtain as much of this base damage. It's pretty useful. So we move to our gear. And I've already said, try and get Garistral Horns for the extra critical strike, Bone Devil's Ribcage for those extra massive stacks of critical strike and crit severity. That's 12.5% on both of those extra stats. The Star Rover's Bracers can be very handy, especially because we move around a lot, giving you those extra damage stacks. Just make sure you keep moving to sustain those 5% damage bonus stacks. And then I'm using the Rusted Iron Leggings for the additional 5% damage. You could use alternative boots to give you like power or your Wasteland Wanderers for combat advantage, but the Rusted Iron Leggings are just kind of unbeatable with that extra 5% damage bonus. But they're lagging behind a little bit nowadays with item level. Alternative to the Gristral Horns is like your Whisperer's Hood of the Quiet or anything that's going to give you the additional damage bonus. Same with armor and same with the arms. So we move to our rings, and ideally you want a ring of the Red Eyes Glare. Gives that power and accuracy. It is a legendary ring from the Vault of Stars, so can't expect many people to have it. So otherwise, try and have ideally melee power damage or ranged power damage. If you tend to use Fleesh a lot, I don't know really why you would in AoE, then you would want ranged. Also, this Con Elemento and Con Motto, it is also ranged damage, so keep that in mind. You might want to have a ranged ring in there instead. You can easily just switch them around. This melee one that I'm currently using will affect Duet. It won't affect Lunge, which is odd, and it will also affect your Vault Stabito. Then we also have our shirt and pants. I'm using the ebony one. It is falling a bit behind within the item level, but it is still a little bit more useful as long as you keep the stamina up. And then pants, just as high item level as you can possibly get. So we go to our weapons, and I'm using the Lionheart set mainly for that extra 7.5% damage bonus when my stamina's full. When your stamina goes down, you gain extra damage resistance, which is good for your survivability. So if you're dodging around a lot, you probably need the extra survivability. They are from Tower of the Man Mage, rather hard to obtain. Otherwise, try get something like, I'm not sure exactly how the Mirage plays on a Bard, but you could always go for it. Just grind it out. Otherwise, of course, there is like the Celestial and also the Masterwork one is not too bad when you're in a full party with them. For our neck, waist, and artifact set, I'm using this Star Choker set, basically the Trictor's Gift, giving an extra 10% damage bonus depending on the different amount of hit points of you and your target. Very good for healing and also DPS. So if you want to both heal and DPS on the Bard and check it out, this is a set that's going to work for both. That's why I'm running with it. As for artifacts, I guess it's pretty hard to obtain the Storyteller Journal with their tails, so don't really bother about it and just get the ones with the high item level of 450. Keep in mind, these three Kragmire artifacts did get a buff to 450. So if you have one of those, you might want to slot it in. I'm using the Staff of Flowers as my primary, just for that extra damage over time on enemies and giving me the extra power and critical strike. Although, I'm really not going to benefit from either of those as I'm pretty much capped on the ratings. But the additional slow effect is very nice. So we move to our enchantments. In my utilities, you can see I'm using Azures. More movement speed means you can get to the next group of enemies as quickly as possible. In our defense, I'm using Azures, trying not to obtain more HP since it will be harder to obtain these stacks from the Gristros and the Bone Devils. Then in offense, I'm just using Assassins for crit strike, accuracy, and combat advantage. Doesn't particularly matter which ones you use, as long as you're obtaining offense statistics, that'll be useful to you. And triple stat enchantments are generally better because you will focus more on those offense statistics rather than the combined rating, which will benefit to all your stats, but not as much to the ones you need. Then we go to our armor enchantment. A bark shield all around is generally the best if you're not getting hit too often, and whenever you do get hit, then you'll receive that extra block. As for weapon enchantment, of course in AoE you want a lightning. You could of course use like just a Vorpal. Can be pretty competitive as well, but the lightning is just that little bit better. Then we go to our modifications, and in my gear I'm generally using like critical strike, critical severity, or power. As for the neck and the waist and whatever, you're using combat advantage. In my main hand you can see I probably don't have it the right one there slotted right now, but you want to be using like your enhanced con elemento. This would give that extra 10% damage to those different con at wills. In your offhand, you want ideally recharge speed. None of the other ones are really great there. The bonuses are just really minimal. And you want like a stat that you need. I'm currently using combat advantage. Could switch it out to like accuracy. Then we go to our race and ability score. As for race, well, for DPS AoE, it's not really going to matter overall. Pick one that you're going to like playing. Because if you choose a race like a Dragonborn and you really don't like it, you're not going to really want to play your character a whole lot. At least if you like looking at your own character. So I've just chosen a human. It gives additional 1% to all of my offense and defensive stats. So that's a pretty big boost compared to the other races. Other races will give like 5% to one of these offense stats or 5% to one of these defensive stats or some of the utility ones. So just choose one that you like, and that's probably going to increase your damage if it's an offense statistic. As for ability scores, I'm generally running Dexterity and Charisma. Dexterity gives crit severity and movement speed, both are good, and Charisma, that extra forte and recharge speed, again, both are good. You could, of course, switch to Strength or Intelligence. If you like to be using that Blaze Flamingo a lot, Intelligence with the extra magical damage boost will help out. And Strength if you're using Steelwind March or Tailwind Mambo to get that extra physical damage boost. But the boost to damage is very minimal, so I just wouldn't worry about it. So we jump to our companions. Of course, I'm using Ixuna for AoE. She's pretty much the versatile best in any situation, jumping between the targets with her Bloodbath and giving them a bleed. For equipment, I'm using a mix of Critical Strike and Combat Advantage with those Indomitable Runestones. I'm using Precision as my enhancement, and my equip powers you can see here are a combination of giving me combat advantage and like crit chance. You can see the Phase Spider, Golden Cat, Flame Sprite, Staldorf's Presence, and Alchemy's Discipline. You could of course switch the Flame Sprite out for the Wild Hunt Rider as I mentioned. We do cast a lot of encounter powers, so this could proc off fairly easily. But again, combat advantage in AoE fights generally isn't the best stat to stack because you can't really guarantee you'll always have it. So we move to our mounts, and here I'm using the new Noble Pegasus's Magnificent Inspiration, giving that extra damage to enemies around it when you summon it, and also buffing up your forte along with one of those bonuses of 15% depending on your role. Using Opportunistic just for the combat advantage, and then in our stable, lots of these mythic collars, just try and get the ones you want. Ideally, you would have like encounter power damage there for AoE. Then you would also have the crit severity and the movement speed. Then we're using a bunch of those mythic insignias. Of course, if you just have them on legendary, you'll be okay, but the higher item level, the more base damage, and that's just better. Using two warlord inspirations, buffing up my companion, a gladiator's guile, and two assassin's covenant. Could of course slot in another gladiator's guile for another 5% movement speed. Just using a mix of skill insignias, dominance insignias, and some brutalities, and that's it. So we move to our boons. I don't have a whole lot of boons here on the bard right now, just grinding out those campaigns and those adventures. But you of course want all the offense statistics ones here, picking up Marathon Runner as you go, and then you ideally want like Forte and then either Action Point Gain or your Recharge Speed. And with your Master Boon, you want that Bloodlust. With your Guild Stronghold, you want one of these offense statistics. I've taken Critical Strike. Defense, try and not take the hit points, just take like defense, pretty neat, just so you can not stack up the HP, so you can proc off your Bone Devils and your Gristros a bit easier. And for utility, either the move speed or the mount speed, depending on what environment you're in. Finally, let's go to my overloads and what buffs I'm using. I'm of course using this Forger's Box for that extra power and one of those statistics. I'm using what we have here, the Devil's Precision, for the extra crit chance and accuracy, along with this extra Rage of Flames for the 5% total damage bonus. Then for my food, I'm just using what you see here, Flask of Potency. I'm using the Sun Lord's Gifts Elixir for accuracy and combat advantage. I'm using the Watermelon Sorbet for the 10% power and accuracy that has been reduced to 5% with the newer versions of Watermelon that you can obtain now. You can, of course, use guild food or inspiration from invoking and some other potions that do stack up. And that's it, really. So hopefully this was somewhat helpful to you guys. Hopefully this build works out for you guys, just as it does for me. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And if I presented this well, consider leaving the video a like. And if you're new around here, consider subscribing. We'll see you guys around. Goodbye for now.